This video is sponsored by Intel and Asus, who sent me the Asus VivoBook S14 S435 powered by the Intel Evo platform. So we're going to talk more about this in a minute. The video for today's topic is once again going to be Excel and specifically shortcuts in Excel. This is a highly requested topic. After my last video on Excel formatting, plenty of people requested this in the video comments. So trust, it is going to be insightful, and I will really show you what shortcuts I used during my time in consulting, how I was productive working in Excel. So we are going to dig into the details of this in a moment, but now I do want to take some time to properly introduce you to the sponsors of today's video. The Intel Evo platform brings the perfect combination of performance, responsiveness, connectivity, battery life and stunning visuals to a new class of sleek, stylish laptops. The great performance is powered by the 11th generation Intel Core processor and Intel Iris Xe graphics. The laptop is designed on the Intel Evo platform and helps you to create, connect and achieve more. It was co-engineered with Intel to provide the ultimate experience anywhere. So I trust you could say that the PC with the Intel Evo badge is verified wonderful. The Asus VivoBook S14 S435 has the new Intel Evo badge, which means it's been verified for premium portability. Finding a new class of laptop is finally as simple as looking for the Intel Evo brand. What I personally like most is the thin and light, stylish design, the innovative number pad, and the yellow Enter key design. I usually always carry a laptop with me in my bag, therefore portability is very important to me. And the Asus VivoBook S14 S435 designed on the Intel Evo platform is doing an excellent job with that. The display is great. It is an immersive four-sided nano-edge display with 90% screen-to-body ratio. This means that the screen takes almost all of the body, giving you maximum screen estate for the size of the laptop. The models have up to 16 GB of RAM and up to 17 hours of battery life. And indeed, I had a great experience when working with the laptop for an extended amount of time. So if you would like to learn more about this, click the link in the video description to check out the Asus VivoBook S14 S435 powered by Intel Evo. We will see more about this laptop because I will create the full video of what we're going to see now exactly on this machine. So you will have the opportunity to now see for yourself what this machine can do when we are working with it in Excel. Before I start teaching you all the shortcuts, there is one thing that is important to me to say, and this is that by no means I would claim that I'm the biggest Excel expert out there. Though that being said, I did spend several hundred hours, probably several thousand hours even, during my professional career in Excel. And as an additional service to you, you can download the sheet that we will be working on in the video description. There's a link there. So feel free to download it, and then you can in parallel work on it while you watch the video and see me doing it. So now I have the laptop here in front of me. I connected a keyboard and a mouse, but the machine that this is running on is the Asus VivoBook S14 S435 powered by the Intel Evo platform. So let me show you the power of all of this. And the focus of today will indeed be the shortcuts, the keyboard shortcuts that you can use just to work on a bit more smooth way in Microsoft Excel. So let's keep us going. And maybe you recognize this file because this was the same file we worked in about 2 or 3 weeks ago when I showed you the video about Excel formatting. So if you have not seen that, I will link it somewhere above here. Check it out. The focus of that video was really to make this sheet look nice. So I will not go over all the key steps, but I do want to do a couple of basic things. And this is really just basic formatting because you see that there are all kinds of font types and font sizes used here. So let's start by highlighting the whole sheet. And you do that by Control A to highlight just the table. But then if you press A once again, it highlights the full sheet. And now what I do is I usually keep to do this manually. So I just type in here Arial and also type in here the font size 10. Now let's move to moving in the sheet. Because what I think is extremely crucial is how you navigate around. And of course, with the arrow keys, you can navigate here in the file, though this always takes quite a lot of time and is not really effective. And one very key movement that you will literally use all the time is pressing the Control key and then moving the arrow keys. So now I move Control arrow down, Control arrow right, Control arrow up, Control arrow left. So if you do this, you can very quickly move over the whole table. This is just the shortcut that you will use in combination with all other kinds of things just to navigate your way around the table in a quick and direct way. Next is about highlighting cells. And many beginners, what they will do is likely they will just take the mouse, highlight it, press down, and then move down like this. And if the table isn't too long with 170 lines or rows or so, this will even work. But if you have a table with several thousand rows, this can take you minutes until you have scrolled down in this manner. So this is not what you do, and instead you use your keyboard once again. And specifically you press Shift, Control, and then arrow down. If you start here, Shift, Control, arrow down to really highlight the full area of the table. Of course, then you can expand that if you then press the right arrow button while you still have Shift and Control marked down, then you can have it all marked. Or now I press up and it has only the first one marked. Now that being said, let's imagine you would want to format here this purchasing price area with a proper number format using, for instance, also a currency icon. So here again, we will do exactly this. So Shift, Control, down to mark this. And now we want to open the format cells menu. And how this works is you press Control and 1 to open this format cells menu. So here, let's imagine this is Great British Pounds. Then you would insert here accounting, press OK, and now you have it all highlighted in this accounting format. We can do the same thing for the quantity as well. Let's highlight this, press Control 1, press now the number format with this separator icon. And now it's all in such a format as well. Another shortcut that you will super frequently use is to highlight whole rows or columns. And again, the beginner might do that with the mouse. You might click here on different rows or columns to highlight them. But of course, the overall goal of a skilled practitioner in Excel is to use the mouse as rarely as possible. So we want to do that with our keyboard as well. And indeed, if you want to highlight a row, what you need to do first is to navigate with the cursor icon to the row that you want to highlight. And then you just press Shift and Space to highlight the row. And indeed, if you want to highlight a column, you press Control and Space to highlight the column. So it's Shift and Space for the rows and Control and Space for the columns. And another way how you can use it really, if you present the model, if you have this model, for instance, projected with a beamer to a wall and you are showing something, sometimes it can be difficult to really follow your cursor because it's not that like visible, not that bold, not that in your face. But if you want to talk about a specific number, you want to highlight that, a little thing that you can do is to just highlight the whole row. And then here you always see the field really highlighted that you have the cursor in. This really helps then the person who's watching this, who's sitting there with you in the room, just to see where exactly you are in the table. Very much related to this is now to insert new rows or new columns. And here what you do is you first highlight, for instance, the row, and then you press Control and plus to insert a new row, in this case, above that. So again, highlight it first. So highlight the row and then Control plus to have a new row inserted above that. And of course, very similarly, it then works with the columns. So first highlight the column, and then again, you press the same thing. So Control and plus to then insert a new column. So depending on what was highlighted first, whether it was a row or a column, Control plus will insert then accordingly a row or a column. This works the other way around as well. So if you want to delete a row or a column, you need to highlight the row or the column that you want to have deleted. And then you need to press Control minus. So in this case, to delete really the columns, or you press Control minus to then delete the rows. Now, besides creating this Excel tutorial for you, I worked with the ASUS VivoBook S14 S435 powered by Intel Evo for several days now, and I can confirm that it is remarkably responsive in everyday programs like Microsoft Office. It is also highly portable, as it is only 1.3 kg light and 15.9 mm thin. So if you would like to learn more about the device, check out the link in the video description. So let's work with some additional data and insert a new column here. Let's call that the average price. Because as you can see here, these are different articles. Here you see the total purchase price and here you see the quantity. So if many of them were purchased. And now to have the price per unit, what we want to do is now just to calculate. So here we would like to divide the purchase price by the quantity, then you just press enter. But what do you do now? Because you want to have this formula included in every single row here. How would you do that? And of course, now you could copy this. And then what some people might do, what beginners might do, is just to try to highlight this in a way like this, just with the mouse, and then insert it here. Of course, here, once again, the problem is that this will take you lots amount of time, especially if you're working with a very long Excel model with thousands of rows. So here the problem is also that you cannot just use the technique that I showed you earlier with navigating around with control and then the arrow buttons, because if you copy this and then press control down, you will end here at the very bottom of the sheet. So you see this, that this is the row 1,048,000 something, right? So this is not possible. And instead, the little hack that you can do is that you move with the arrows, one to the left, you move here to the last filled column, and then you move down with control, arrow down, and then you're at the bottom of the table. And then you move with the arrow signs once to the right, and now you can use the little shortcut that I showed you earlier, namely control, shift, and arrow up, to then have it all highlighted up until this point, up until where we started here in the row 3, as you can see. And if I now press control and V, you have it all populated up until the end of the table. And maybe this looked a bit complicated, but it's actually pretty easy and straightforward. So let's just go back and let me show you how you would do this quickly, right? So this was the starting point. We go up and we have it all populated. So it's like something that will really go into your blood. It's very straightforward, very easy. So we just talked about copy-paste. The one thing that we will need very, very frequently is pasting values. Because what you see here is that what was copied is not really a value, not really a number, but always a formula. And here, another little shortcut that you can use is F2. So if you press F2 on such a formula, it highlights all the cells that are involved in a formula, right? So we see that here the one cell was divided by the other cell, and this is just what we copied over. By the way, if you press Escape, then you can always leave this mode here again. But here the problem is, or maybe it's not the problem, often this is exactly desired, but here indeed we copied over the formula but not the values. And of course what this means is that here if this field changes, of course this value changes as well. But sometimes we don't want that. Sometimes we don't want to copy formulas, but we want to copy specific values, specific numbers that then don't change anymore. And here the manual mouse way to doing that is to then highlight this, to then with control C, copy this, and then here with paste, there is this drop-down menu, and then here you could go on paste values, and then if you would click on that, you would see that now these formulas were replaced by the specific numbers that you worked with. So let me teach you how you would do this with shortcuts. And indeed, first you need to highlight this and copy it, and then once it is copied, you can press Ctrl, Alt, and V, and then this paste special menu pops up. And here there are lots of things you can do, but specifically what you want to do now is pasting values. And you see that if I now press V once again, here now the radio buttons jump to values, and then if I press Enter, then I have it all replaced with the values indeed. So once more, a bit more quickly, highlight, Ctrl C, V, V, and it is replaced. This is how you paste values. Pasting values is for sure something that you will also use super frequently, so definitely worth the time of learning this. So let me show you one more thing that is very important when you work with fixed references, and for that let's include here a new column, and let's imagine that we would want to show the purchase price, so what we see here, though now in GBP, so Great British Pound 1000. So we want to have that in 1000. And let's just imagine as a little helper we here include the number 1000, just to have this here. And now what you would of course need to do is to divide this number by 1000. And here in order to now make it a bit easier for us, we just highlight this field here. Now of course the problem is, if you just copy this over, it doesn't work. Why doesn't it work? Well, here, and I'm pressing F2 now once again, you see this, if you copy this down, this range here moves again, which is why you now need to fix the reference here of this G1 cell. And if you want to learn more about references, about relative and fixed references, I once even made a complete video just covering that. I will link it somewhere above here as well. But here the little thing is that you can use is to press F4. And you see now I pressed it once, and now we have absolute fixed references for both the column and the row. And now with F4, you can just toggle through the individual modes. Of course, what we want to do here is to fix it. And because then if we use this and if we copy it then over, just showing the level that we did even before, you see that this is now already copied. Now I forgot to highlight these cells. So now let me show you an additional thing, and this is very helpful if you work with very complex formulas, but sometimes it's difficult to just really keep the overview of what actually is going on. And for demonstration purposes, let me show you just a very random nonsensical formula. So completely nonsensical, just to show us now a bit more complex calculation. Now, of course, if maybe you have an error, maybe something looks weird, maybe you want to understand what exactly is going on, if you look at expressions like this, then what you can do is you can evaluate the formula by just looking what the result of individual parts of the formulas is. And by doing that, you highlight the part that you want to know. And then if you press the F9 button, it shows you what the number, what the output is that this specific element is returning. Now if I press Ctrl Z for returning, it again shows the formula. And I can do this with other elements as well. I can, for instance, do this with this D5 field. So here we know that D5 is this 1,005,725. If I press F9, this is exactly the number it gives me. I can indeed also evaluate more complex expressions. So if I want to, for instance, know what all this is, I press F9 and then it shows me here the number. So once again, this is extremely helpful if you want to debug a more complex formula, especially maybe if a formula is returning an error and you want to know what specific parts of the formula are producing this error. This is something that you can frequently use. I hope these tips resonated with you, and let me know in the comments what the favorite tip for you was, what the thing is that you will most likely use in your daily workflows as well. So if you would like to learn more about this, click the link in the video description to check out the ASUS VivoBook S14 S435 powered by Intel Evo. And once again, if you have any things to share, any tips that you would like to share to the From Learning community, please leave a comment in the comment section as well. If you would like to play around with the sheet that I just worked with, I will provide it as a download for you. There's a download link to this sheet in the video description. As always, if you took any value out of this video at all, please hit the like button for the YouTube algorithm and also subscribe to the channel to stay up to date on all my content. And then I also want to say a big thank you to all the members of From Learning. You're really making a big contribution to this channel. Thank you so much. This was Heinrich from Learning. I'm releasing new videos every single Saturday. So stay tuned until next week. Looking forward. Until then, good weekend to all of you, and bye bye.